it's my great pleasure to introduce Jennifer Tung. There's so much I want to tell you about her if I can, but I don't think we can at this moment. Can you hear me okay? Okay, fine. So Jennifer Tung has been with us since, over 20 years, when Muskoka Chautauqua was Muskoka Lakes Music Festival, right here in Windermere. Jen was part of that. Since then, she's had an amazing career. Am I still okay? Okay. She's on the faculty of the Royal Conservatory. She just won an amazing fellowship for women in leadership, conducting music across Canada. What else can I say about Jen? Well, Jen will be introducing the youth from the Toronto City Opera for your enjoyment this evening. She will introduce them one by one, and she will let you know what the program is going to be. So, so without further ado, please give a warm welcome to Jennifer Tung.
Thank you. Can you guys hear me okay? Yeah? I have to say that this is like the first time that I have performed in this kind of condition, which is, I mean, but you know, you cannot get more one with nature than this, right? So thank you so much for coming out. You know, like, despite this weather, we're very happy that you're here, you know, with us, and we really hope that you enjoy the concert. So I just want to talk a little bit about the artists that you will hear, you know, like this evening. They are all either upcoming singers who will be singing with the Toronto City Opera, which I'm the artistic director of. We are an indie opera company based in Toronto, and we are different than most other indie companies in Toronto because our core of the company is actually a non-audition community chorus. We put on traditionally two full productions a year with piano, but we have all of the lighting, we have a stage director, you know, as well as costumes and, you know, and movement. And we hire up and coming young artists in the local area to give them more opportunity to perform. And so without further ado, I'm going to introduce the first singer of this evening. Her name is Angela Maria Sanchez, and she's from Toronto. She's a graduate of the Glenn Gould School of the Royal Conservatory of Music, and I actually had the pleasure of working with her when she was at the GGS, and she is still this day, you know, is my student. And of course, as you know, I've been involved in this festival for 20 years. Of course, I was 5 years old when I was involved at first, so I'm only 25. but she has made her role debut as Antonia in Hoffman with a Summer Opera Lyric Theatre in 2017, and then subsequently was Mistress of Novices in Suor Angelica in the Hawaii Performing Arts Festival. She has done lots of competitions and has placed first in NATS, you know, a singing competition, as well as a scholarship winner in the Toronto Kiwanis Music Festival. She will be gracing our stage at the Toronto City Opera this upcoming season as the leading role of Santuzza in our production of Cavalleria Rusticana. So for those of you who do come down to Toronto, this will be happening in May. And so I hope that you will all come, you know, come and see her. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce Angela to come onto the stage, and she will tell you all the pieces that she'll be singing. So let's welcome Angela.
I'm right here. Thank you so much for that introduction, Jen. Can you guys all still hear me? Good? Okay, how about this? This is good? Okay, this has been my first time singing live since the pandemic, so thank you so much for coming here today and supporting live music in these weather conditions. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm really excited to perform these three pieces from three remarkable leading ladies. The first one is from La Bohème, a timeless, arguably one of Puccini's most beloved operas. In this scene, Si mi chiamano Mimì is where we're introduced to the character. And what's so lovely about this character is something that I think we can all relate to, especially during this difficult time in the pandemic, is she is someone who loves the small things, who loves things that really don't have a price tag, like the sunrise, the perfection of a rose, the verse of a poem. She's really pure at heart. It is also this scene where Rodolfo falls in love with her. Kind of, this is this, the done deal. And we as the character fall in love with her. And spoiler alert, you know, because she loves life fully, unfortunately, she dies at the end of the opera because of a terminal illness. But this beautiful piece just really showcases the purity of Mimi's heart. So please enjoy Si mi chiamano Mimì from Puccini's La Bohème. Okay. As requested from the audience, we're going to wait until the rain subsides a bit.
Oh, damn. So should I? Let's try it.
Thank you.
Macina che la vien fuori d'ora importunare.
Shift you over just a little bit.
Thank you. Thank you. This next piece is from a zarzuela. What is a zarzuela? It is, basic definition is Spanish operetta from Spain. The Spanish used to write this usually comedies, usually showcasing flamenco dancing, which is really fun. This particular piece is from a spicy lady who is actually in Aleppo, Syria, trying to find her man. And she is rolling down the streets of Syria, saying that she's from Spain, and that you can tell from her eyes, from her face, from her figure, everything. She also goes ahead to explain to the townspeople that Spanish people love and hate each other at the same time. And so she explains this and saying that sometimes her lover hates her and sometimes they love each other, but that's the Spanish way, that's how it goes. So please enjoy De España Vengo from Pablo Luna's El Niño Judío.
Madrid. Me quieres, si no me quieres, ítano mío. Me quieres, si no me quieres, ítano mío. Mira qué pena verse así despreciada siendo morena. De España vengo, de España soy, de España vengo, de España soy, y mi cara serrana lo va diciendo, y mi cara serrana lo va diciendo.
Thank you very much. Now we move to more serious matters. Visi d'arte. Another one of Puccini's most beloved operas, Tosca. This scene, Tosca is pleading, more like praying. She knows that her lover, Cavadarossi, is in big trouble. He's being tortured for information. Not going to spoil the opera, keep it brief. But she's pretty much wondering and asking God, why is this happening to me? I've been nothing but loyal to you, pray for you, I go to church. And why is this happening to me? Like, where did this misfortune come from? So please enjoy Tosca's plead, Visi d'arte by Puccini's Tosca.
Timo
Thank you. Thank you, Angela. I hope you guys enjoyed this. What a great start. Right? And this is also such an emotional moment, you know, for us artists, you know, to be have not performed in front of a live audience for so long. And it's just amazing. You know, there's nothing that can replace, I mean, all the technology in the world does not replace live music. So this has been really amazing. I'm going to introduce the next performer, originally from Vancouver. Baritone Michael Robert-Broder has found himself living in Toronto for the last 12 years. He's heard frequently in oratorio and opera throughout Ontario and the rest of Canada. Michael, hopefully, is going to be joining us for our first opera and concert production at the Toronto City Opera of Verdi's Nabucco, you know, like in the fall. And for those of you who saw our fundraiser that was a little bit earlier this year, Michael actually graced the stage and he sang, you know, like for us. But if you have not, you are having a real treat because you will be hearing him tonight. So without further ado, Michael.
Thank you, Jennifer. It's a joy to be here tonight. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'd like to start off with the prologue from Leoncavallo's Pagliacci. Tonio, in this Before the Opera Begins, tells the audience that the things that they're going to see on the stage, it's just acting. But not to be fooled, because those emotions that they see on the stage come from real places, and the people they see walking across that stage are real people who bleed and cry just like you do.
Son false e dispasimi ed il nostro martir non armatevi. No, no, l'autore ha cercato invece pingervi uno squarcio di vita. Egli per massima sol che l'artista è un uomo. Per uomini scrivere deve, ed al vero ispirava sì. Siccome s'amano riesseri umani,
rendere l'odio i tristi frutti dell'olori spasime, o la rabbia udrete e risacci. Ascoltate come gli svolto. Andiamo, incominciate.
Moment gets the audience every time. So don't consider yourselves too tricked. I'd love to sing two songs for you now. The first is by a French composer, Henri Dupac. It's called Chanson Triste, a sad song. The title's maybe a little more misleading than it ought to be. It's maybe not the most joyful song out there, but it's a song where I find a lot of hope in it. The speaker speaks about how in his partner, he sees so much in their eyes, and how that which he sees in their eyes gives him strength. And there's a hopefulness in it that I think is maybe not warranting the title that Dupac gave it. The second song is very much correctly titled. It's called Cuore Ingrato, Ungrateful Heart. So maybe a better follow-up to Chanson Triste. The song, the singer sings about this lover who he's had, who is completely ungrateful, but, you know, thank God now everything's in the past, and that doesn't matter anymore. And he definitely believes what he's saying. Sur tes genoux. Now to some scorned Italians. Ci parole amare, perché tu pari ancora a me, tuor miente catarì, non te scurda, cattaggio da te occorre, catarì, non te scurda, catarì, catarì, che dice al venere, sciuballar cadade, spasa me. Piense, tu non te ne cure. Corre, corre, ingrato, t'hai pigliato alla vita mia.
Italians, you know, they know how to grab your heartstrings, you know, with their music. Thank you, Michael. Wonderful performance. You know, I mean, you guys of course notice, you know, singers are, you know, standing here, but there's always a great performance of any singer, or back up with an orchestra. In this case, a human, one-person orchestra. Let me introduce my partner in crime. He's the music director of Toronto City Opera, and I've had the tremendous pleasure of working with him for the last few years, Ivan Jovanovic. He started his music career in Serbia at the Belgrade Faculty of Music, where he completed both his bachelor's and master's in piano performance. And in 2004, he joined the Belgrade Opera Orchestra as a repetiteur and concert pianist. And that's only the start of the story. Then he moved here in 2013 and attended University of Toronto's collaborative piano degree, and where he got his master's under Stephen Philcox. And in that same year, he won the Gwendolyn Kolofsky's prize in accompanying. And he now works as a regular vocal coach as well as harpsichord player at U of T. And he has actually been a pianist with Toronto City Opera since 2014, but it wasn't until a few years ago when I also joined the company that we actually had a chance to work together. And I have to say, he is one of the most amazing person to work with, and without him, the company simply wouldn't do. He is our personal orchestra. He is our vocal coach, you know, like for all the singers, and it's just been amazing. And so he is actually going to entertain us this evening and playing selections from Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin. Ivan.
Thank you.
seriously, are we lucky or what? I have more. Ivan. And just so you know, I happen to also play piano, so it sounds really hard, and it is indeed very hard what he just played. So it's amazing how many notes, you know, like that you play on that piano, and he's even not doing it on like a piano. It's on a keyboard, which actually makes it way harder. So, good job, Ivan. Congratulations. So now going back to a little bit of singing. And I'm going to introduce Lauren Esty, who will be our next singer. She's from Quispamsis, New Brunswick. I actually had to ask her how to pronounce the name. I was like, this is so cool. I'm like, but I don't know how to pronounce it correctly. So that was actually really, so learn something new every day. She's currently pursuing her DMA, Doctoral of Musical Arts at the University of Toronto, under Professor Monica Witcher. She has a very interesting research for her DMA, and it centers on the intersection of Indigenous vocal aesthetics and early music. So I mean, that's very, very interesting. This is very cool. This year, Lauren placed second in the annual U of T DMA recital competition. Congratulations. She has been featured in many different roles, such as Lauretta in Puccini's Gianni Schicchi, the sorceress Belinda in Purcell's Dido and Aeneas, Donna Anna from Mozart's Don Giovanni, Susanna from Floyd's Susanna, which I believe you will hear something from that role this evening, the title role of Puccini's Suor Angelica, and Violetta in Verdi's Traviata, lots of different roles. And we're very lucky that this coming season she will be involved with Toronto City Opera in both of our productions, playing the role of Anna in Nabucco, as well as Lola in Cavalleria Rusticana. So without further ado, let's welcome Lauren.
Good evening, and I can't tell you enough how much it means to me that you're all here with us despite the rain and the mosquitoes, and it just means so much to be in front of a live audience. This first selection is from Alban Berg, his seven early songs. This is the third in the set. It's called Die Nachtigall, the Nightingale, and it's quite rhapsodic in nature. It's really an outpouring of poetry, and it talks about a nightingale who has sung all throughout the night this sweet, mournful song, and the song has been so powerful that it has caused the roses to bloom. So I hope you enjoy.
Sind von mir.
this next song is from Eric Korngold, another set called Dreilieder, Opus 18. It's the last of the set. And Korngold wrote so much for opera. And after the Second World War emerged, he moved to California and started to write for early cinema. And this song has a lot of cinematic qualities to it. It's even in the poetry, it feels very romantic in the way that early cinema feels. And it talks about how the world is so silent and asleep, and someone has awoken in their dream, and they're meeting their loved one, and they can hear God's violin playing in the background. And it's just this almost over-the-top, cheesy poetry, but it's also so beautiful. So I hope you enjoy. This is Welt ist stille eingeschlafen by Korngold. An aria from Carlisle Floyd's Susanna. This is Susanna's first aria in the opera, and Susanna is just the sweetest, most romantic character, kind of like an Anne of Green Gables meets New Hope Valley, Tennessee. And she's 18, she's an orphan, she is living in extreme poverty, but she feels the richness of the world around her, and she delights in all of nature and every little star and every detail of the world. And this song is a celebration of that part of her soul, but it's also an expression of her desire to leave New Hope Valley and to see the city and to self-actualize. And then she withdraws from that and she thinks, what if I miss home? But then she remembers she can always come back. And what a feeling to sit with in a time when maybe we haven't been able to see our loved ones. So I hope you enjoy it. This is Ain't It a Pretty Night.
Leave it someday and sky so heavy with stars tonight that it could fall right on all of heaven and cover us up and cover us up in a one big blanket of velvet and
don't feel bad. That's also one of those situations that's always, you know, make people clap because it was so good, right? And then it's even better than they continue to sing, you know, which is fantastic. So I'm the last performers of this evening. And it's actually, it's so lucky because originally I was not going to be in town. And then I find that myself that I am. And seriously, this has been such a long relationship with Muskoka Chautauqua, with Gail and Gary, and I've sung in many different venues, you know, on the church, on the island. I've done a few concerts there, you know, I've done concerts here at Christ Church that's close by. This is a magical place, you know. It's not just a magical place just because of nature, but it's also the arts and the inspiration, you know, like that's here. So I'm going to depart a little bit from opera, that you have heard opera and art song. But I think I don't really need to introduce the following song because I think you'll know when he starts to play. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you find me. No, why can't I? Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up when the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. The Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. This next piece is kind of a meeting in the middle between classical and musical theater. It's called Dream With Me from Leonard Bernstein's production of Peter Pan, which you basically don't see anymore. This is one of the few songs that is still surviving. And it's Wendy's song singing about her unrequited love with Peter Pan. So here's Dream With Me.
Dream.
Thank you. And before I do the very last piece of this evening, I want to thank you again for being here and for supporting Muskoka Chautauqua, which is something that is so important that I think it needs to continue to grow. And I really want to congratulate and thank you, Gail and Gary, whom I've known for so many years, and they have not, you know, let go of this dream since the very beginning, you know, through many, many different stages, and here we are. And so thank you very much. Thank you for everybody, you know, who has made this happen, and of course for all of you, for your support, without which would cannot happen. And thank you for all the performers this evening, you know, that have come up, you know, and perform. And hopefully, you know, for those of you who do venture down to Toronto or maybe do live in Toronto, come and check us out with Toronto City Opera and torontocityopera.com. You can follow us so that you will know what's actually happening with our season that's upcoming. I don't think that I need to explain this song, so we're just going to go. So weary when troubles come and my heart burden be, and I am still await here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains, you raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
So is this still on? Yeah. Thank you so very much for Jennifer Tung and Toronto City Opera. We really appreciate that. What a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful evening. We also want to acknowledge Diane Adamson Bredar, Opera Muskoka. And thank you so much, Diane, for all the work you've done in keeping opera in Muskoka, and we really appreciate that.